In the previous video, we looked at three different variations of making 3D objects with 3D bodies. In this video, we're going to look at the other two variations of 3D objects, and that is to make them with 3D shapes. Variation 4 extrusion does not work with all 3D objects. It only works with 3D shapes. Let me show you what I mean. I'm going to grab a shape off our basic shapes and place it on the screen, doing the Control C, Control V, and moving it over to the other side, just like we did in the previous video. And I will put these files out on the website if you want to download them for a quick reference. And I'm going to come down here and create a polygon of a rectangle, just like the one we have above it. But if we look in the lower left-hand corner, it says Polygon 4 Corners Selected. When I come to our shape, it says Shape Selected. When I click on the Polygon 4 Corners, if I look down here on our drawing toolbar, we have this extrusion on-off that is inactive. If I click on the shape that we added, we see that the extrusion on-off is active. And clicking that creates Variation 4 Extrusion 3D Shape. We'll also see that we've got our 3D Settings Toolbar that becomes active. We'll talk about that more in a few minutes. And I'll put a little note here that Variation 4 Extrusion does not work with polygons. Our last or fifth variation of making a 3D object is an extrusion 3D shape, and that's done with font work. So I'm coming down to the font work gallery. I'm just going to select this first one, and to change what it says, I'm double clicking on it and clicking off it so it accepts my change. I want to make this a little smaller, and I'll move this under my original, doing the Control C, Control V, and moving it over to the right so we have our before and after like we've done in all the previous examples. And this one again, I'm doing a Control C, Control V, and going to copy this one down a little bit here. Now with my font work selected, I'm going to come down to our extrusion on off and click that on. The first thing we notice is we have our 3D settings toolbar. We have our special handle that works for our font work. We also have, I don't know if you can tell here, but this is our font work toolbar. We can change that to any of our font work shapes that we like. I created this copy of our font work so I could select that, go into Modify, Convert to 3D so we could see the difference. We see this does create a 3D object, but looking in our lower left-hand corner, we have 3D Scene selected. When I click on our font work that we extruded with the extrusion on-off, it says Shape Selected. And here we see our font work toolbar as well as our 3D settings. When I click on our 3D object, we can no longer use it as a font work, and clicking on it a second time brings up our rotation handles that we can rotate. And if we go to the center handles, we rotate it in 3D. When we come over to our font work and click on that, I try and click on it a second time, and I don't see any rotation handles coming up. So I'm going to come down to our effects mode toolbar, bring that up, and I'm going to click on the rotate. And you don't have to bring it up. You can click on rotate from where it is. And when I go on these corners, it rotates around our rotation point. And if I go over these center handles, I get the prohibited symbol, the circle with the line through it, telling us that we can't rotate it like that. How we get around this is we come over to our 3D settings toolbar, and we'll look at this first one because it's the extrusion on off, the same one that's down here on our drawing toolbar. These next four are the tilt down, up, left, and right. So I can tilt this down a little, or maybe I want it more up. I can tilt it to the left, which is basically the 3D rotation. And I'm clicking on it a second time to go back into selection mode and bring that back down a little. Coming back over to our 3D settings toolbar, we've got this depth. And this is the depth of our 3D. We can put it to an inch. I can put it to infinity. Or I can bring this back to like a half inch. This next one gives us our angle. The default here looks like it is from the southwest. I'm going to change that to the opposite direction. And it does a little rotation too. Now if we look on the bottom here, we also have perspective or parallel. If we go back over here to our depth and change this to about 4 inches, now we'll see the difference between perspective, where it's going off into the point, or parallel, which is just keeping all the settings even. Sometimes the perspective has a little better look to it. And when you have a small 3D, it's kind of tough to tell if you're using the perspective or not. This next one here, lighting, that one's pretty obvious. We can light from different angles, and we even have a brightness, normal or dim. How dim do you want the light? How bright do you want the light? This very next one, surface. This one, we're going to show it on the square because it'll come out better. And this last one, 3D color, let's make this maybe red. And then if we come up here to the front, we can change the area color. We'll make that like a light blue so we can see the blue and red. Going back over to slide one, we want to select our 3D shape and come back over here to surface. Now we've got four things here possible: the wireframe, matte, plastic, and metal. The plastic and metal functionality is not working as of this version, which is version 3.6.4.3. And I'm getting this information from the LibreOffice online draw guide. So we have our matte surface, which is the default, and our other one is wireframe. And the wireframe shows up a little better on the box than it did with our text. So there are our five variations of creating 3D objects.